If I eat bread, just straight bread, it makes me have the hiccups.
Well, Jamie, lovely to meet you.
Thank you for having me.
By the way, I watched this film with the real life person you played.
Rusty?
Yes.
Did he walk out?
He didn't.
Okay, that's a relief.
I was like, I was so captivated by the film, but I was trying to watch his reaction at the same time.
Yeah.
And he was definitely leaning forward and
he
getting
very
engaged.
That's not how you hold a gun. He looks like a ballet dancer. That's not how you enter a building. That's not aggressive enough.
I think you did a pretty good job.
Thank you.
Again,
that's so nice of you.
I am not a trained SAS soldier.
Right.
Out of interest, how much time did you get to spend with him, if any?
A good amount of time. He was, we shot the film in New Zealand. So he was down there mostly for the kind of pre-production, the training. We did a kind of 5-6 day boot camp where we would get up at 5 a.m. every morning, full fatigues, weapons, everything. And they built a mock-up of a building. And we would kind of run these drills, clearing rooms and lots of shouting, lots of gunfire, and they would put smoke in there and fires and stuff. So he was down there for all that and kind of it informed a lot about the kind of mental state that you have in such a kind of high pressure, kind of intense environment.
What did you guys all get up to in your sort of downtime? If you're in New Zealand, did you go and do any crazy activities?
No, they kind of like to do strange things there. They like to throw themselves off of like mountains and that stuff, like kayaking, like hiking, cycling, yachting. Disgusting.
Didn't do any of that then?
No, I'm really not an outdoorsman at all.
Okay, just more of a barman?
No, I was just trying to catch up on sleep. I mean, the time change there is crazy.
Out of interest, how much did you know before? Because I'm going to be honest, I was completely ignorant. I didn't really know about this, which I feel
really?
Is quite bad. I know, isn't that? I was born like 9 years after it happened.
9 years. Okay, so you're not that far away from me, because I was born 6 years after it happened.
And you knew.
But, you know, my mum used to watch all those, like, the 10 most shocking moments in Britain's history, like on Channel 4, you know, those kind of compilation shows. And that's where I first saw it. I saw, like, the images of those guys, like, dressed in black with the masks on, kind of abseiling down this pristine white building. And it... Because it happened in England, like in London, it kind of really stuck with me because like, this doesn't happen in this country, you know, not the country that I kind of grew up in or that I understood. And after that, it just forever kind of stuck with me. So when I had this script kind of delivered to me, I was like, oh, wow, like we actually get to go inside the building. And that's what movies should do. You know, they should kind of bring you along and give you an experience. And hopefully that's what this does.
Yeah. And obviously you're back in the UK, but you live mostly in the US, am I right? So what do you like to do when you get home?
Eat English food.
Do you miss it a lot?
Pub food, yeah.
Is there anything you keep with you when you're away?
Oh, the weird thing is you can actually buy a lot of the stuff over there. Like I always buy Marmite. I'm one of those people. I like Marmite. You can get all your HP, PG tip. They have all that just in the market now, which is awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
What's your best way to eat Marmite? What's your favourite method
Toast.
Just on toast.
Yeah, yeah.
Got to have butter?
Oh, yeah. We were just talking about that. If I don't, I'll get the hiccups.
What? That's a strange reaction.
Yeah, no, I don't know why. I've always said that. If I eat bread, just straight bread, it makes me have the hiccups. I don't know why. It's weird.
Very
I think it's hereditary. My mum does that as well. Cool.
Hereditary, or you just, you know, you saw your mum do it and now you do it.
Yeah,
who knows?
Yeah.
Nature or nurture.
Yeah, she hiccups kind of violently. Yeah, I don't know what that is. Maybe, is it a hernia problem? I might need some surgery at some point, isn't it?
Because of your bread consumption. Yeah. But I've got to ask about Tintin because there's been so much kind of confusion about it. Are you even able to keep up with
what's going on?
Yeah.
I mean, I think everyone's just got incredibly busy schedules, you know. Peter's producing stuff. I mean, he did make a trilogy called The Hobbit recently, and that kind of took up some time. And Andy's like a movie star and, you know, has franchises here, there, and everywhere. But I think, you know, Peter Jackson has such a great sensibility for Tintin. I would really love to see a Peter Jackson-directed Tintin. So fingers crossed we can kind of all just kind of get on the same page and figure it out.
Yeah, so it's pretty much everyone is still wanting to do it.
I think so, absolutely. I mean, I hear from him all the time. I'm always kind of like... You know, we heard from him recently, you know, make sure that he's doesn't get too old and we'll have him back in his motion capture suit soon. You know?
So it kind of just, because you're in a motion capture suit, it kind of doesn't matter. Like you,
it
you
really
can
doesn't,
wait.
But I don't want to be playing Tintin when I'm 40.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, that's not
okay.
Cool.
Depends. It's the question of how old is Tintin.
Yeah, ageless.
True.
Undefined.
Obviously, last year you got to film with Julie Walters again.
Yes.
What was? Have you kept in touch over the years, and what was it like sort of getting back?
No, I mean, we don't really keep in touch, but it's lovely to see her. I mean, we have such fun memories together of doing that. She actually told me, she was like, she was so anxious before she did the kind of dancing number with me. And I had no idea about that when I was a kid because I was just so unaware. But she was like, I was so anxious before I did that. I was like, you did great. That was so good. But she's lovely. I mean, she's just great. She's a national treasure. I mean, you see her like walk onto the set. And just everyone from crew to the cast, they're just completely in love with her, you know, and have such massive respect for her. And she's brilliant. I've seen the film. She's brilliant. She's brilliant in it.
Does that make a real difference, do you think, like, when you think about when you first worked with her when you were a child, and were you maybe less aware of the fact that she...
No, I was aware of her, I remember, because as a kid, my uniform was just wearing an Arsenal shirt and, like... tracksuit bottoms. I used to dance in that, live in that all the time. And when my mum was like, you're going to meet Julie Walters today, I was like, oh no, I should buy a shirt. And I remember I went and bought like a dress shirt so I could meet Julie Walters.
Tequila.
God, I'm sweating.
Girl, shake that laffy taffy.
That was terrifically embarrassing.
Ooze, like yummy smells.
Hi everybody.
Hi, I'm Amy.
That's me.
This is a stalker. This is my worst nightmare.